My name is Hambali Balde. I have a research associate at Agriculture Canada. My work focuses on farm scale measurement of manure emission from liquid manure storage over 2 years. Liquid manure from dairy farm is a large source of methane, and many studies find the emission underestimated using the when using the standard the inventory model, the standard inventory model. And the objective in this study were to measure methane emission from liquid manure over 2 years and to compare the result with the inventory calculation. It was conducted at the commercial dairy farm in near to Ottawa in Canada, and there were about 150 milking cows, and the manure passed through the liquid solid separator where the portion of liquid was solid was composted and used for bedding, and the portion of liquid was stored in the outside manure tanks. And the concentration measure, we measure the concentration using the open pass laser that you can see here, set placed in upwind and downwind to the manure tanks. And we measure the wind complement and the air temperature using a three dimension sonic anemometer. And then we calculate the emission using a Bagua-Lagrangian stochastic dispersion model implemented in wind tracks. We have also measured the manure depth to calculate to the manure, the quantity of manure stored in the tank and the quantity of volatile solid, as well as the temperature, the manure temperature inside the tank. We find, as you can see in this figure, from July to November, the temperature, the manure temperature was higher than the air temperature. That means using the air temperature for the modeling can underestimate the emission. The emission calculated using the model. And also, you can see here the manure stored in the tank and the volatile solid was higher, the maximum was in August in years 1, and the maximum was in October in years 2. And when you look at the methane emission over the full years, the most of emission occur from July to November in both years, and when you look only the years 1, the significant emission occurred from July to September with the maximum in August, and in years 2, the significant emission occurred from July to November with the maximum in September. When you compare the 2 years, you can see here the emission during years 2 was lower than the emission during years 1 up to the August due to the manure removal in years 2 in July. And when you take the overall full years, you have years 2 has 26% higher than cumulative emission than years 1 due to the emission from October and November of this year. As well, when you see this figure, when we scale according to the quantity of money stored in the tank and the quantity of volatile solid, years 2 has also reduced also, years 2 has more 57% of emission than years 1. You can see here also, we did the small release to evaluate the accuracy of the method that we use in this study, of the tank. And you can see we have a good recovering within the 10% that we expect. In conclusion, we can see here when the farmer reduce the emission, the farmer can reduce the annual emission by 26% when they apply the manure early in fall. Also, we find the measured concentration emission was higher than the emission measured calculated by the inventory model. That's why there need more evaluation on farm scale. Methane emission are needed in order to better understand emission process and develop a resilience model.